Can I fix this iPhone the Apple-approved way? So a little while ago, Apple launched their self-service repair program, something which is theoretically designed for people like you and I to go online, buy the parts, get the tools, everything we need to fix our broken phones ourselves. My main question is, does it make sense for you to try to repair this yourself the Apple-approved way, or should you just take it to an Apple store and let them do it for you, or even take it to a third-party repair shop and hope that they can put a screen in here that doesn't make iOS yell at you constantly that it is a non-genuine Apple part? You have any third-party friends? Because Apple sure don't. So, we're gonna start on apple.com, go to the support page, and then I need support for Apple repair. Well, yes. Self-service repair is intended for individuals with the knowledge and experience to repair electronic devices. That's me. So I'm using an iPhone 12 for this process. Now this is the oldest device that Apple support, at least on the iPhone side. And I think it's actually a good candidate for this because while it's a few years old, it's still a very usable phone today. And the main issues with this particular device is it does have a very shattered display, which it does technically work, but it's quite jagged. And it does have some sort of scuffing on the outside as well as a battery, which is a little bit lower on health. So my goal here is to replace not only the display, but also the battery with genuine Apple parts. I see what I need. I need the battery, which is a part number, and I also need the display, which has two part numbers. Okay, tools. That seems like a lot of stuff for a screen, man. Okay. Oh, what? Wait. This is what they're talking about? This is like a whole, like, display heater device. Wait, hold on a second. I was expecting to do, like, you know, the blow dryer thing, not a whole machine. I've heard that there is a way for you to rent tools that you don't own. Now, clearly, I don't own a 6.1 inch display heaty uppy thing, so I guess I'm gonna rent one? There are 33 steps to remove the display and 28 steps to install a new one. I mean, I'll give them that these are very thorough instructions. They've got good animations, good text, or at least it looks good on the surface. Let me purchase some genuine Apple parts next. Wait, hang on. There's a return part credit. I guess the way it works is I spend $49 on a toolkit, which theoretically has everything. It comes in a case that weighs 43 pounds and a second case that weighs 36 pounds. Are you trying to tell me this is environmentally friendly to ship 70 plus pounds of cases back and forth? I knew we were in for one today, but holy
hugs,
dude. You know, here's the other thing. So it costs $50, that includes the shipping. But I guarantee you, it cost them more than $49 to ship these cases back and forth, right? The serial number is required and will be shared with Apple. This number must be from the device that is being repaired, or you may encounter issues that prevent the completion of the repair. Okay, serial number has been accepted. The repair manual ID is a 6-character code in the repair manual. I have to scroll through this whole thing and find the 6-digit code. Where's my 6-digit code? Oh my God, it's right here. That's so stupid. It's not even in the manual. It's in the page with all the manual links. Oh my. So let me just get a little grand total here, including my $49 rental of $409.94. My grand total after buying the parts and renting the toolkit and returning everything, assuming nothing goes wrong, is $333.62. Just gonna point out that I could buy an entire iPhone 12 refurbished for $326. So when I saw this box show up, I'm like, sweet, that's all my new components. So we've got our security screws, the screen, all that kind of stuff. But then I saw the tools.
Okay.
So if you need to repair your iPhone 12, it just is a simple case of 70 pounds worth of tools and your actual parts that you need. All right, let's see what we got in case number one. So this is our heated display removal fixture. Okay, that's a chungus right there. Wow. Also, I like it uses an old iMac power cable. That's just lovely. Now it does come with a prepaid shipping label to send back to Apple, which is nice. Next, let's open up the second one. Yeah.
This is like Apple's passive aggressive way of saying, here you go, enjoy.
No, you pick what we're having for dinner tonight. Oh, I don't care. We'll eat whatever you want. So this press is the display press. Oh God, these things are so legit. They're so like heavy and like just solid metal. What the hell am I looking at here? Dude, this is solid aluminum. Like the entire thing. Like,
did you say aluminium?
Aluminium.
Oh my God, the influence. Oh my God, you're right.
It's Johnny Ive told me that it's called aluminium.
Oh my God.
It is a solid chunk. And then we have a couple of boxes, which include all kinds of stuff. So we've got tweezers and suction cups, our entire tool kit as well, with all the bits and drivers that we might need. There's no turning back now, my friends. Let us begin. We have to start, regardless of whether you're doing a battery repair screen or whatever, we have to start by replacing this display. So we're going to take the screen off, we're gonna remove the speaker, then we're gonna take the battery out, and then new battery in, speaker, put it back, and put a new display on it and call it a day. Hey, look, if I can do it, anyone can do it, right? Let's crack open an iPhone, shall we? So before we actually turn this on, we have two tiny little screws on the bottom of the phone that we need to remove using their incredibly fancy little screwdriver. So we've got our two little screws, the only screws that are gonna be easy, I think, in this whole process to remove. Now it is time to fire up our display press. So this is ready to go. So now I'm going to take the phone and put it into this pocket. So you can see that it just kind of slides in like this. And then I'm going to clamp it down, which is just going to make sure it's not going to go anywhere. Woo! Okay, I'm going to put on my heat resistant gloves. Ah, okay, cool. So we now have 2 minutes for this to heat up. There's high likelihood of me messing something up right now. So I'm like on edge, you know? It's like you're about to go out and do something exciting. 2, 1. Now we have a 15 minutes. So we only have 14 minutes to finish this. Otherwise it's gonna get too hot and it's gonna get angry at us. Slowly turn the knob counterclockwise until the display begins to separate. So it's on there, hopefully. So now if I unscrew it, it's gonna pull it out. Oh, can you see that? I actually see the screen's actually starting to pop out a little bit, but it's only coming out on this side, not the other side. Yo! What I can do now is I can actually take this cutter and I'm just gonna sort of slide it out to make sure it is partially removed. So I'm gonna be careful because I don't wanna go too far in because it could cause problems. Okay, suction cup is released. Okay, so press this button. And that, my friends, is a partially replaced display. So all we've done, even though that seemed really scary, is we've just heated up the display to the point where we've got it started. So now I'm gonna probably let this cool a little bit and release the phone. Oh, okay, this phone has been released. So now we have our repair tray, which is where we need to place the phone to do repairs. I really don't wanna put any pressure around these cracks. Like, can I slightly do it or? No, no, you know what? When I start pushing down, it literally cracked a little bit more. There we go. Okay, we're in. I'm just gonna start sliding. Oh yeah, boy, let's go. Let's go. Yeah, we did it. Okay, that display is fully loose. So now I'm going to pick the iPhone up. So I'm done with my little clip here. Yeah, I'm just gonna move the whole phone. So I'm gonna attach it to these suction cups here. Okay, so now push that in firmly. So hopefully the suction cups do the thing. And then as I gently pull the phone toward me, this display should stay up here. So are you ready? You know what, it's resealed a little bit. It settled back in. Because I pushed it into the suction cup. I squished the whole thing. Wait, hold on. That's okay. Wait, it's actually coming out. It's coming out. Hold on.
Oh, God.
I got it. It's look. Yeah, I got it.
Oh,
I got it. Yeah, boy. Hey, we did the thing. That's a screen there and a phone not there anymore. So now that we are inside the phone, what we need to do is just remove the actual display itself. So there are two screws here that I need to undo, and I'm assuming I'm gonna pull that ribbon cable out to fully detach it. These tiny screws are gonna get lost in the iPhone and never be seen again. That's actually really helpful because these screws are like, they're to the point where it's probably hard to see on camera. Can you just get a close up of that? That is the size of the screw we're talking about here. Screw number four, and then they say use tweezers, but my fingers are better. Oh, ah! Oh no, that was bad. Oh, we're good, okay. Hey, okay, so battery is now, I believe, disconnected. So we'll clear that out of our way. And then, yeah, just remove the display. And theoretically, there we go. Goodbye, broken iPhone screen. So now, let us remove the speaker. The thing is, there are a lot of screws in here. And I'm glad that these guides are quite detailed because there's a whole lot of little screws that looks very similar and right side by side, but you don't want to undo some of them. You definitely want to undo others. Oh, that's it? That's the speaker? Oh, dude, there's not even like a cable or something to it. So it has these two little pins, which I assume is how the actual speaker runs. And that's it. That is your iPhone speaker. That's actually really neat. They really gave us exactly what we need to actually make this repair happen. I appreciate that. That
is much better. Okay, so this is one tab. So basically I'm just trying to peel all the stuff off so I can actually get to the adhesive itself. That looks like a thing that's supposed to happen right now. Yeah, all right.
I don't know where they get this adhesive. This is like some of the stickiest stuff I've ever seen.
That, my friends. Oh wow, I actually had a lot of tab left. So this is the, so I did get all the adhesive off the top. I didn't get it off the bottom, so that's where it snapped. There you go. You want a little adhesive action. That's what holds your battery in place. All right. Now it's time to begin by reinstalling our battery, and then we will do everything else in reverse order. Now, obviously, if you're watching this video, this is not a tutorial on how do you put it back together an iPhone. But the main thing I'm trying to learn here is that for someone who has never done this before, is this a possible repair? And so far, while I don't obviously have it up and running yet, the answer is yes. The answer is this is actually quite complicated, but ultimately not incredibly difficult to do. Okay, speaker has been reinstalled. It is time to install our battery. So left, I mean, it should just go in. I don't think there's a whole lot of anything I can do to like, I don't say mess it up. It is definitely slightly not straight. So this is my battery press. So I need to lift this up. And now we're gonna attempt to lock it down and hope that it works and I didn't. I mean, the battery is in there. It's not straight, it's in there, and there's a little wiggle room, so we'll just find out. So I'm going to flip it down, okay, and so we're on board. Here goes nothing, so one. I will say, I don't know how much this roller's doing, I could've just probably pushed it down, but whatever, it's fine. Okay, and now, with any luck, our battery's installed! Hey, we did it! I need to remove this from the panel and gently shake the phone to sound, see if anything sounds loose. Also, if the battery sounds loose at this point, you're supposed to remove the battery and get a new battery. I'm not even kidding. If you don't install this right, throw it away and try again. I actually understand this is pretty well aligned, mostly because there's also little lots of cuts in the plastic, which goes around the components. So as I'm putting this in, I think we're okay. Press plate on top of the enclosure, okay? That's on here. Here goes nothing, so we're gonna push it down. And then we gotta wait 30 seconds. Okay, so we'll lift up. this is a little concerning. I think we need to get out of here. It's not good. I'll get you out, little buddy. I'll get you out. I'm not doing this a bit, by the way. This is a real pull out. Pull down the lever and pull out. Oh, okay. Christ averted. We're all fine. We're all good. Nothing is broken, right? Yeah, okay. Okay, so I guess I'll use tweezers to pick up this little tab. Okay, I think that's fine, right? Oh, yeah, no, that is fine. That is fine. Because I see that there's still more plastic underneath. So I can just peel this off now. Now it is time to get my trusty suction cups back because we're gonna start putting a display back in. This is just gonna hold the display in the correct spot so I can connect all of our little ribbon cables. Okay, and there we go. That's in there. These absolute mad lads just tell you to just close it up, seal it, call it a day. Let's fire up the iPhone without the screen fully assembled and see if it works. Okay, so we are plugged in and now, yeah, boy! That's an Apple logo on my screen! Here, just hold this. Yes, the touchscreen works. Let me confirm that everything works. So screen functions, touch seems to be fine. Oh, face ID issue detected. I wonder what could be wrong with my face ID. It also is telling me that my display is not a genuine Apple product, which actually is normal because once I close this back up and do it for real, I need to put in the serial number and activate it. That's fine, all this stuff is fine. Okay, so I'm gonna put this back into place. Re-suckify it, close this thing up, and we will be good to go. So I have manually pushed the display into place, so it is largely correct now. However, there is a potentially slight gap right here where I'm kind of squishing that cable a little bit, which unfortunately wasn't quite correct. I'm gonna set this into position. Okay, here goes nothing. And now, I'm gonna replace the iPhone. pop it out here. And can I feel a gap? Oh, I don't feel a gap anymore. It squished it down. Before I get too excited, let me find my tiny little screws. Flush. Take off the screen protector, and that, my friends, is a brand new display and brand new battery on our iPhone 12. The last step here is to run our system configuration. With that, I am going to press the volume up and down buttons and then plug it into power. Initiating correct components. So, we've gone through the step. Battery health, 100%. It all shows up like it's a legitimate, authentic battery. That, my friends, is our repaired iPhone. Is Apple's self-service repair worth it? When you look at the financial side of this, it does not make sense to use self-service repair, like, at all. In fact, a couple of these repairs would have been cheaper to have the Apple Genius Bar do it for you. So I paid $234.36 for the new display assembly for this iPhone 12, and that is including the rebate I get for shipping back the old display, right? So I'm gonna quote that in all of these prices. So $234. Now, if I took this to the Genius Bar, it would cost $279. So I am saving some money here, but you also have to factor in the $50 I spent on tools, which puts us at $5 more than having Apple do it themselves. Now, there is the option to purchase a new display from iFixit. Now, this is going to run you $145, although like Apple, if you send in your display, you'll get a refund. In this case, it's $10 off. So I'm gonna quote iFixit at $135. Now, that is a significantly better deal. And unlike spending $50 for the Apple tools, iFixit is only a $5 upgrade. Although for $5, you're getting a heated display pick versus a full-on display press and battery roller and everything like that. So the level of tools is significantly going to be less, but you're going to get that at a way cheaper price. Now, when it comes to replacing the battery, self-service repair looks a little bit more competitive. So after I return the battery that came with the phone, it's gonna cost me $46 for the replacement. Now that compares pretty well with $89 to get a battery replacement at the Genius Bar, but keep in mind that that is not including the $50 I would have to pay on the Apple tools. Now iFixit does look a little bit better here in that it is $40 for a new battery and again $5 for the tools to get in. But I will say that while the screen was a fairly involved process, the battery is a step further because you of course have to take off the screen and the speaker, and you have to pull the battery out. So this is an area where I actually, even though the Genius Bar is more expensive, would probably spend the extra 40, 45 bucks and have them do it. That being said though, if we actually talk about the overall value of these repairs, a battery actually makes sense. So this is of course all based on an iPhone 12. So these prices can slightly change if you're using a newer phone. But the problem is that we're talking about spending $200-$300 repairing this iPhone, which is only worth like 300 bucks. And there's a certain point at which it's kind of hard to justify spending that much money to keep this phone going. But if we sum all this up, I will tell you this, as much as I want self-service repair to be a viable option, it's not. They're serializing all these certified Apple components, which means that when you do go to iFixit and buy third parties, or if you went to your local repair shop that's not using authentic Apple parts, you're getting parts that are giving you constant errors saying, hey, I'm not authentic. Oh, you can't see the battery health anymore. Oh, your True Tone doesn't work. Like all of these things that feel very anti-consumer. It feels like, on one hand, Apple is saying that they support self-service repair. On the other hand, they're making it basically impossible to have any other option out there that's a smooth, seamless thing. I wish that alongside self-service repair, they would just ease the fuck up when it comes to all the serialized stuff. I gotta say, like, I'm pretty cynical about this whole self-service repair thing. Like, it just is clearly not the answer for literally anyone besides Mother Nature.